Hello aviators, Sky here, and after meeting the main turboprop from North America, it's time to meet the main turboprop from Europe. One of the few produced modern aircraft of this class, and of course very popular for several decades. Let's take a look. ATR 42 and ATR 72 are two brothers which made up a family of twin-engine turboprop airliners developed by the French-Italian ATR joint venture in the early 1980s. The story of these planes is long and full of adventures. Everything starts a bit similar to the de Havilland Canada story in the early 1970s. These times were rather unclear for the field of turboprop airliners. Jet engine technology was developing at a tremendous pace. New large airliners conquered main routes, and younger models were conquering the original ones. Turboprop engines were perceived as a temporary compromise between outdated piston engines and advanced jet engines, which soon would finally secure absolute dominance in the industry. Regional turboprop aircraft flying at that time were developed mainly in the late 1950s and were considered rather obsolete, but the industry, not seeing great prospects, was not particularly in a hurry to create a replacement for them. Trouble for some, luck for the others. The 1973 oil crisis and the sharp rise in energy prices redrew the market. High fuel consumption of the jet engines, previously perceived as a perfectly acceptable compromise, now turned out to be a serious problem. Long-range transportation by large airliners remained more or less profitable, but flights over short distances by regional vehicles were often not paying off. And while no one was trying to make turboprop long-range airliner, it was quite possible to play with these engines on the regional market. One of the first results of such a game was the Canadian Dash 7. The plane with short takeoff and landing performance, but four engines, on the one hand did not gain any demand among commercial operators, but on the other proved that there is a need for aircraft of this class. De Havilland Canada had begun to create a new, more suitable aircraft, the future Dash 8. Seeing the potential success of this plane, European aircraft manufacturers also got to work. Their aircraft were developed in the Netherlands, Sweden, France, and Italy. Moreover, the project of the French and the Italians turned out to be the most complex and promising, which on one hand would enable them to conquer the market in the future, and on the other added the risk of failure due to a lack of resources. Aviation is not a cheap business. At the same time, the European aviation industry went through a stormy period of reorganization with mergers of previously local manufacturers. The most bright example of this process was, of course, the birth of Airbus industry and the creation of the breakthrough A300 airliner in 1972. Remaining in the trend of European cooperation, the French Aerospatiale, now part of the Airbus Corporation, and the Italian Aeritalia, now part of the Leonardo Corporation, decided to work together on a new turboprop aircraft, sharing all available technologies as well as the risks. In 1981, a joint venture agreement was signed. The company received the name ATR, which in French means Avion de Transport Regional, and in Italian, Aerei da Trasporto Regionale. In English, it's something like Regional Air Transport, long and boring. Apparently, they couldn't find a beautiful word, such as Concorde, in two languages. The new company was supposed to be the executor of the entire life cycle of the aircraft, from design to sales and service. The work continued quite intensively. In the summer of 1984, the first aircraft created by the company made a test flight in the airport of Toulouse, France. The aircraft that received the index ATR 42-200 was certified in 1985. During the tests, the plane underwent a number of changes, and the serial production was started for its modification, receiving the index ATR 42-300. Its commercial operation began as early as December 1985. The ATR 42-300 received 1800 horsepower Pratt Whitney PW120 turboprop engines. With a maximum takeoff weight of 37,300 pounds, or 16.9 tons, it could carry 48 passengers at a distance of up to 459 nautical miles, or 850 kilometers. Not too far away, but for Europe it is quite enough. The cabin had a layout of 2+2, and for its role was quite classic. All the analogs were give or take the same. The plane was very successful. Already by 1986, the number of orders reached a sufficient volume in order for ATR to decide to expand the model line and increase production rates. A big step was the creation of another full-fledged modification, the ATR-72. The aircraft, with a stretched fuselage, accommodated 72-74 passengers, which expanded the potential market for the model. The decision was right. At the moment, 70% of all ATRs are of the model 72. The first flight of the aircraft was performed in 1988. In parallel with this, the European manufacturer continued to expand the geography of deliveries, and in the same 1988 entered the North American market, receiving orders for several dozen aircraft from the Texas Air Corporation and Trans World Express. Already by 1989, ATR had a portfolio of orders for 400 aircraft, having reached the business plan indicators. At that time, more than 200 machines had already been delivered. The ATR production sites are located in Italy and France, where they are still in operation. The fuselages and tail sections are made at the Leonardo factory near Naples. The wings are made at the Airbus factory in Bordeaux. The final assembly center, test base and supply center, as well as the ATR headquarters, are located in Toulouse. The ATR-42 and ATR-72 models are being unified and produced on one line, which allows to significantly optimize the work and maintain the supply of both models. In many regards to this solution, the ATR-42 is in fact the only turboprop aircraft with the capacity of less than 50 seats, which manages to be produced until now. In the 1980s and 90s, during a period of low fuel prices, the turboprop aircraft market decreased, while the competition increased. To maintain efficiency in competition with its peers, the ATR-42 continued to be upgraded. The 42-300 and 42-320 models differed in engine versions and were produced until the mid-1990s. A step forward was the creation of a model ATR-42-500. It made the first flight in 1994 and received new engines, propellers, and onboard systems. Takeoff weight also increased to 18.6 tons, or 40,100 pounds. The older model was also upgraded. The first 72-100 series was replaced by the 72-200, equipped with more powerful engines, as well as new systems, mostly similar to the 42-500 model. Unification was a great advantage of the family, and was followed strictly. A feature of the ATR family was the rejection of the auxiliary power unit. Yes, the APU is very useful on the ground, and allows to work with engines turned off, but they are not needed in flight, and you still have to carry them. On large planes, it is necessary, okay, but on small ones, the decision is already not so clear. Optionally, ATR still installs the APU, but in the basic configuration they offer other solutions. Firstly, the ground infrastructure is used to power the aircraft, or it can use the generator from the engine, that is, on the little Model 42. The Model ATR-72, equipped with more powerful and voracious engines, has a special economical system. In engine number 2, it is possible to start the turbine on a minimal mode, only for the generator, without propeller rotation. This is called the hotel mode. The series production of the aircraft continued quite actively, although low fuel prices reduced demand. In the beginning of the 2000s, ATR delivered their 600th aircraft to customers, and the mark of 700 aircraft was overcome only in 2006. Despite the fact that a number of competing models were actively leaving the market, the pressure of a new generation of regional jets affected demand. The Embraer E-Jet, as we know, was very popular. In 2007, ATR announced the creation of a new generation of its aircraft, exactly when Bombardier announced the Q400X program. A large-scale upgrade of the family was supposed to lead to the creation of the ATR-42-600 and ATR-72-600 models, more efficient, comfortable, and easy to use. The aircraft received upgraded PW127M engines with 2,160 horsepower on the model 42-600 and 2,475 horsepower on the model 72-600, with the possibility of a temporary increase in power in special modes, for example if one of the engines fails. Add to this the new Hamilton standard 6-blade propellers, and the power plant becomes quite awesome. The onboard systems were also upgraded. A new cabin, a new glass cockpit, avionics, etc. In addition, a few years after, a next local modernization of the cabin gave the ATR 72 increased capacity, from 74 to 78 passengers. The earlier modest flight range was brought to the more relevant for our time. The 42nd is now flying at a distance of up to 700 miles, or 1300 kilometers, and the older brother up to 800 miles, or 1500 kilometers. The ATR 72-600 prototype took off in July 2009. The younger brother left the ground in March 2010. The ATR airplanes are some of the most successful in the class at the moment, and are distinguished by high reliability. However, their history could not avoid accidents. During the period of operation up until 2018, the ATR 42 and 72 aircraft were participants in 63 serious accidents and crashes, with the death of a total of 674 people. Yes, the airplane does not beat safety records, but it must be kept in mind that this is the statistics of 35 years of operation of 1,500 planes. The company is trying to expand the possibilities of modifications by creating cargo, special and patrol versions. Considering the drop in demand for ATR 42, they are looking for the possibility of creating the version with a shortened takeoff and landing, which will allow the aircraft to work on runways up to 800 meters long. On the basis of the model ATR 72, the possibility of creating the version with an extended fuselage and a capacity of up to 90 passengers is being considered. Deliveries were also helped by a new wave of rising fuel prices. Cost-efficient and reasonably effective turboprop aircraft are in steady demand, especially in the countries that do not have a developed airfield infrastructure. ATR occupies almost half of the regional aircraft market, with a capacity of 50 to 90 passengers, in fact sharing it with Bombardier. They managed to cut the market pie pretty well, while not getting into frontal competition with new generation jet airliners, which are slowly moving towards increased capacity and range. Aircraft production continues, and ATR remains one of the leaders of this modest but important niche. And that's all. Subscribe to the channel and don't forget to like the video. Fast flights and soft landings to you.